I'm Keith Henry Brown, a New York-based art director, illustrator, and writer, and a huge jazz and comic book fan.
I was briefly a cartoonist at Marvel Comics, and later in my career, I was named design director for Jazz and Lincoln Center in New York, working with Wynton Marsalis. I currently work in advertising as an art director, but I also enjoy creating jazz-based illustrations and posters and album covers. Recently, I did a poster for the National Jazz Appreciation Month for the Smithsonian. Now, for some time, I've wanted to create a graphic novel based on my musical hero, the great jazz musician, Eric Dolphy. And that's why I'm here, to ask you if you can help me to realize this dream. Doing jazz-related art is something that comes naturally to me, ever since I was a small child, listening to jazz records and looking at the covers in my parents' home. I really enjoy the connection between the visual art and the musical. But why Eric Dolphy? Well, Eric Dolphy was a brilliant jazz musician who composed and played music with other great musicians like John Coltrane and Charlie Mingus. He was also a great innovator, and he used instruments that had never been used in jazz before, like the bass clarinet, with great facility. Even though he was young, he somehow connected with the veteran musicians, who immediately took them under their wing. They really loved him, especially Mingus, who wrote a song called So Long Eric, which is about a time when Eric had to leave early the tour that they were doing. But one of my favorite stories about Dolphy is one his mother told about how he'd listen to birds outside of his window when he was a young boy and try to duplicate their songs with his flute. He would rehearse and rehearse, trying to get that sound. He pretty much spent the rest of his life doing the same thing, using bird sounds and a lot of other things in his music that had never been heard before. And that's what I'm trying to capture in this book, what it was like to be a musician and an artist, an African-American in that time. That's why he's always been an inspiration to me, and I'm hoping that people will read this book, will find him an inspiration too.